Government takes over Burmese river bridge operations. Man chopped to death by brother-in-law. Guyanese urge to brace for heavy rainfall and possible flooding in the coming weeks. And in sport, West Indies batting collapse as India win first T20. These and more right now in this our Monday, November 5 edition of News Update. Good evening, I'm Sandy Ramutar. Thanks for joining us. The government has nationalized the operations of the Burmese River Bridge to ensure the proposed toll increase is not enforced. Public Infrastructure Minister David Paterson claims the move is in the interest of public safety. Both the opposition People's Progressive Party describe the move a gimmick.
Today, the Ministry of Public Infrastructure, in a statement to the press, revealed that the government is temporarily nationalizing the operations of the Burmese River Bridge, claiming that the move is beneficial to the public.
In accordance with the power conferred on me as minister in the Burmese River Bridge Act, the powers of the concessionaire to operate and maintain the Burmese Bridge will be exercised by the government of Guyana from the 5th of November 2018. We will do everything in our power to alleviate the disruption to the public and maintain a smooth transition during this period.
The minister noted that government will manage the bridge's operation until he says otherwise, to ensure there is no longer a threat to public safety. While the authority of the operation of the bridge falls in the government's hands, the minister assured that there will be no retrenchment of staff.
There will be no changes to staffing complement, suppliers or contractors during this transitional period.
The matter will be taken to Cabinet this week for the government to make a pronouncement. The Burmese Bridge Company, that wants to increase the toll by as much as 360%, on Friday dispatched a letter to the minister with an ultimatum. The company claims that the toll will not be increased if the government agrees to extend its operation of the bridge for the next 19 years. According to the agreement, the bridge is to be handed over to the government without a charge in 2026. Government has not responded to the proposal. However, Minister Paterson reassured that there will be no change to the present toll structure and all exemptions presently in place will remain in effect. Meanwhile, efforts to contact Minister Paterson to clarify why the decision was taken before it goes to Cabinet to discuss the government's position proved futile. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
Meanwhile, PPP's executive member Anand Nandlal claims that the possession of the Burmese River Bridge by the government is bullyism. Nandlal claims this is a return of the PNC's 7 days error. He believes the seizure of the Burmese Bridge exposes the naked authoritarian nature of the government. Nandlal says the seizure of the bridge will cause irreversible damage to Ghana's image as an investment destination. You're watching MTV's News Update. More news on the other side of the break. Stay with us.
At Optique Vision Care, we value the power of your sight. And with our team of eye care professionals, you'll be in good hands. Come experience our comprehensive eye examination using state-of-the-art technology and specialized diagnostic equipment at 4 convenient locations in Mahaika, Grove, Giftland Mall, and East Street. At Optique, we care, you see. Call us today, 227-7744.
The secret is out. Tyo's Future Shop is the absolute best place to shop if you're looking for quality products at the lowest prices in the widest possible variety. Choose from a vast array of custom-made quality wooden furniture in endless designs, electrical and household appliances, clothing, sell phones and accessories, and much, much more.
Oh my God, so much thing this store got! Me confused! And a price low too?
Tayo's Pizza Shop and Household Appliances, located at Anna Katerina, West Coast, Demerara. Free delivery available.
Credit, now me know the secret!
And like, oh, you know the secret?
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick bet for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
Mark?
I'm in the kitchen.
This is amazing! I love your tiles.
Make an impression with the finest tiles imported by Lens. Lens has a huge selection of various tiles for your wall, floor, and pool needs. All of our tiles are of grade A quality, which are the highest quality tile rated. That means they last longer and are less likely to damage or crack. We're the sole distributor for many reputable companies around the world. At Lens, we have special deals for contractors and bulk shoppers. Shop at any of our three locations to get the best in tiles. Lens, our product, your creation.
South Dakota will ignite with top riders and drivers from the Caribbean and North America as GMRNSC hosts the final round of the Seaboard Marine Caribbean Boat Racing Championship. It's going to be an epic showdown on November 10 to 11. Adults 2,500, kids 1,000. Action starts at 8 a.m. Who will be crowned a Group 4 champion? Can any rider top T. Muhammad? Will Kristen dominate in his radical? Boat racing action you won't want to miss.
Your one-stop decor solution for gala dinners, weddings, birthdays, cocktail functions, backdrops, props, and more, check out Exclusive Decor Design, Ground Floor City Mall. We have a wide variety to suit your stylish seating and table decor, exclusive centerpieces, colorful maro, and much more. Working with a small budget? No problem. We've got you covered. Call 225-4434 or 657-0166. We listen, we create, you enjoy.
Planning a cleanup? We can help. Sivan's Waste Management skip bins can be provided for home renovation projects, yard cleanups, or construction sites. It's simple. Step one, just pick up the phone and give us a call. Step two, we deliver the skip bin size of your choice. Step three, load the skip with all of your junk. And finally, step four, we take it all away. It's that simple. Bins are also available in various sizes, so there's no job that's too big or too small. Call Sivan's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
A 39-year-old Paradise Village, the East Coast Demerara resident, was beheaded earlier today after his brother-in-law went berserk.
Reports are that the deceased Justin Peterkin, in the company of the now suspect, visited his father-in-law's residence located at Lot 1322, Section C, Block Y, Golden Grove, East Bank, Demerara, about 8 hours 20. At the time of their visit at the residence, the elder man nor his daughter, the victim's wife, were not at home. It was sometime later that persons in the area witnessed the suspect chopping away at Pitikin in the yard. According to one eyewitness, Daniel Boutin, who was in the area visiting his child's mother, as they were in the yard, he heard a grunting sound.
See, man, he bossing up, in the yard, IP. See, now when look back, the man going to send come out for the ammo. It's like telling she now, take this man back for you in the yard. I'm gonna run around the yard with that all. And I gotta run inside and lock up. So at the same time, I left she now coming inside for go and check this through. And hear a knocking. When he looked there, he leaned over chopping away upon him on the neck. Get the chop upon him on the neck and lashing into the ammo. So gosh, and I say, hey, man killing the man there. And she come and she think a joke. When she come and see, I run she inside with me that all and I run inside and lock up. I go up in the veranda now.
Meanwhile, the deceased man's reputed wife, Cassandra, related her reaction upon receiving the dreadful news.
I don't know what happened. I left for go to annex. What can I hear? Come home. Auntie, so I beg you, sorry. So I could tell you, sorry. Auntie, so I'm sorry. Auntie, so I could tell you, sorry. Your mother, nobody I know yet.
According to the eyewitness, it was at that time the suspect, who resides at Princess Street, Worthmanville, escaped from the scene of the crime. The suspect was later intercepted by the police and is now in their custody. Pitakin sustained wounds to his head, upper body, neck and shoulder. His body is currently at the Lycan Funeral Parlor awaiting a post-mortem. Reporting for MTV News Update, Lushona Gomes, Cornelius.
The Office of the Director of Public Prosecutions on Monday withdrew a murder charge against a rural constable of Suzdike, East Bank Demerara, who was accused of the murder of 15-year-old Ricardo Singh. In October, 28-year-old Tony George appeared before Chief Magistrate Anne McLennan, charged with the indictable offence, and was remanded until October 23. It was alleged George murdered the Diamond East Bank Demerara youth on July 9, 2018, on a Suzdike public road. When the matter was recalled before Senior Magistrate Leron Daly, the man's lawyer Dexter Todd argued that the charge is barred in law and that there is absolutely no evidence upon which the charge was instituted. The attorney argued that his client was wrongfully charged, and so Police Prosecutor Richard Harris was asked to seek further advice from the DPP. When the matter was recalled, the DPP conceded with the defence that the accused was wrongfully charged by the police with offence of murder and as such discontinued the charge. George then walked out of the judging magistrate's court a free man. We tell you now that scores of residents of Alexander Village braved the rains on Saturday evening to listen to the plans of the People's Progressive Party councillors who are seeking election in next Monday's local government elections. A sizable crowd was also addressed by PPP General Secretary Bart Jagdeo, who reminded residents why they should cast their ballots in favour of the PPP. Here's that story. The People's Progressive Party continued its local government campaign in Georgetown over the weekend at Alexander Village. The party's General Secretary Bharat Jagdeo used the platform to compare the progress between the current government and the previous PPP administration. He accused the government of dwarfing projects which were fashioned under the previous administration.
And in 3 years, I think all the residents of Guyana can discern several trends emerging that will characterize this government. The first is that it's uncaring. I will give evidence to support my contention tonight. Secondly, that it is the most corrupt government in our entire history since independence. Thirdly, it is the most incompetent government ever in our history.
The General Secretary said the status of the economy is largely due to the heavy overspending on unprofitable projects and increased taxes. He promised to have taxes removed from a number of goods and services, and in some cases, decrease the percentage taxed.
As soon as 2020 comes, we have to get them out so that they can't do more damage to the country. And we will, because as soon as we inflict a crushing defeat on them at these local government elections, we're starting the campaign to take our country back.
The General Secretary assured residents that the PPP will be working seriously to regain power in 2020. Meanwhile, the residents of Alexander Village were reminded of the alleged widespread corruption being perpetuated at City Hall by the APNU AFC appointed councillors and town clerk.
Do not be fooled. This is not about Royston King. And this is not about Chase Green. They will put them back again if they win the city, and they will continue with the wickedness at City Hall because they have the majority. And that is why we have to fight to take control over City Hall.
General Secretary of the People's Progressive Party, Bharat Jagdeo. He was at the time addressing residents on his local government campaign in Alexander Village, Georgetown. Jagdeo reminded of the many corrupt practices that were unearthed at the Commission of Inquiry into City Hall. The local government commission launched the COI in September after a series of complaints of corruption and financial matters were received. The former president also accused the council of handing out millions in contract to government affiliates. Against that backdrop, he urged residents to use their discretion to cast their ballots for the list of PPP candidates. He assured that the list of candidates for the Georgetown municipality is one with more integrity and progressive attitude.
Guyana's hefty food import bill is going to be drastically reduced by the year 2020. These are the worries of the Chief Executive Officer of the National Agriculture Research and Extension Institute, NARI.
Guyana ramps up a hefty US$200 million in food imported annually. This contributes significantly to the Caribbean's food import bill, which is over $4 billion each year. However, an agriculture expert has noticed the climbing bill and has vowed that it will be reduced by the year 2020. During an exclusive interview with the Chief Executive Officer of the National Agriculture Research and Extension Institute, NARI, Dr. Odu Homnot, he claimed that Guyana must grow more.
Within the next 2 to 3 years, we may be able to be self-sufficient in the number of commodities that we are currently importing.
Dr. Homnot also listed the major agriculture import of Guyana, which he says the country has the ability to produce more on a large scale to meet the local demands and also to export.
A major import for us is the ingredients that they use to make livestock feed, which is basically corn and soybean. But with investments now taking place, we hope that, you know, that can be a boost for us as well.
To preserve agricultural produce, the Institute has recently worked on disaster risk management practices in the outlying regions to ensure crops and livestock can continue to thrive regardless of El Nino or La Nina. Guyana currently imports agriculture byproducts that are made locally, such as bottled coconut water, plantain chip, and tamarind balls. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
A two-day empowerment leadership conference is being held at the Autechon Convention Center under the theme When Women Prosper, We All Prosper. The conference is aimed at helping women to develop holistically. Here's Kippany Jordan.
So the conference does not just covers how to develop your business, but it helps you to understand how the law can affect you. It helps you to understand how your mental health can also affect you. So we cover different areas and aspects of development for women.
Chief Executive Officer, CEO of Community Health, Abigail Lonk. Co-founder and Chief Executive Officer, CEO of Java Coffee Bar, Evie Guturan, explained the essentials of starting a business. She also gave some pointers on how to be successful.
What is my unique purpose? What is my unique selling point? What is the greatest thing about me that I can not only bring a level of business acumen to myself, but what can I bring to my community? And the second principle is affordable loss. What is it that I don't mind losing?
The Women's Conference is scheduled to last for the next 2 days. I'm Kippany Jordan reporting for MTV's News Update.
More news after the break. Stay with us.
This Christmas, get a loan for your dream car with an extended repayment term. Spruce up your home with that renovation you always wanted and take advantage of low or no down payment. Get new appliances so you can cook up a storm. You'll get same day approval. Plus, you can win a getaway to a destination of your choice. Visit RepublicGuyana.com today to find out how.
Republic Bank, we're the one for you.
The voting process. Once you have been identified as the voter you claim to be, you would be given a ballot paper that is stamped at the back, top, and bottom halves in your presence. On the ballot paper, provision is made for you to vote twice. Once at the top section where you vote for the party or group of your choice in the proportional representation component, and once at the bottom section where you vote for the party, group, or individual of your choice in the first past the post or constituency component of the election. Make your mark in the box provided on the right of your choice. After you have voted, fold the ballot paper as shown by the election official, dip the first joint of your right index finger in the ink provided, and place the ballot paper in the ballot box that is there for this purpose. You would then have to peacefully depart the polling station. For more information, contact GCOM on 225-0277-9223-9653, email pro@gcom.org.gy, or visit GCOM's website at www.gcom.org.gy.
Introducing the new Softex toilet tissue, now available across Guyana. Softex is silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp. Softex is soft and gentle to every touch. Even babies can use it. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. The choice is clear. Choose Softex toilet tissue, super soft and super durable, guaranteed.
For the best in truck spares, Daff and Cummings, it's A1 Auto Value New Road Freedom Hoop on the west side. Check them out today for seals, alternators, filters, air valves, pistons and rings, air dryers, shocks, bearings, and a whole lot more. Parts and accessories for cars and minibuses. Call today on 254-0890. 64 New Road Freedom Hoop on the west coast of Demerara. A1 Auto Value. Performance without compromise.
Welcome back, you're watching MTV's News Update. The Hydrometeorological Office has issued an advisory for stakeholders along the coast to take precautionary measures as water levels are expected to rise, with higher soil saturation in the last week of November until the end of January. Northern Guyana is expected to transition into the short wet season in the last week of November and will last until the end of January. This is according to the Hydrometeorological Service, Ministry of Agriculture. During El Nino, the average sea surface temperature across the Pacific Ocean will be above the climatological average. This will lead to lower rainfall amounts and drier conditions. During the short wet season, the country usually experiences between 26 and 47 days of rain. Of these, up to 4 events are very wet, with potential flooding in 2 events can lead to extreme flooding. However, the seasonal climate outlook model suggests these numbers will be less than the upcoming wet season. But there are still chances of flooding along the coast and in the northern areas. As such, stakeholders along the coast are advised to take precautionary measures as water levels are expected to rise with high soil saturation. The Hydrometeorological Service also predicted a gradual buildup of heat, which is expected towards the end of the season.
Minister of Public Health, Valda Lawrence, has revealed that the Maternal Mortality Committee is investigating the deaths of 2 babies at the public hospitals. The Shana Gomes Craniness reports.
Minister of Public Health, Valda Lawrence, via a telephone interview, vehemently stressed that allegations of negligence at hospitals are thoroughly investigated.
I have not received a complaint from any of the persons who are involved, notwithstanding all such matters are investigated by the committee, the Maternal Mortality Committee, and when that investigation is finished, then a copy of that report is sent to the CEO, sent to the director in charge of primary health care, and I get a copy so that we can take actions. In terms of the doctors, and so of course everybody wants persons to follow rules and standards.
Minister Lawrence stressed that such agencies ought to step up in their efforts to better handle such matters. On October 24, a Katy resident lost her one-month-old baby at the Georgetown Public Hospital Corporation when he experienced complications from a fever. The woman had related that her child was injected several times in an attempt to locate a vein. After finally being administered saline, the child suffered a seizure and later succumbed. On October 20, a 37-year-old mother of three lost her newborn after giving birth to him at the West Demerara Regional Hospital. It was reported even though the woman was initially informed she needed to undergo a cesarean section, she was later induced to give birth vaginally. Reporting from TV News Update, Lushona Gomes, Cornelius.
Persons are dissatisfied with the operation of the Georgetown Public Hospital mortuary and have come out accusing the staff of keeping their relatives' remains outside of cold storage.
According to Nalini, only name given, her mother Sarani Mahabir was admitted to the Georgetown Public Hospital Corporation on Saturday morning. Nalini explained that it was not until her scheduled visit at noon the said day that she got the dreadful news that her mother had passed.
When we questioned the nurses over there, they were so arrogant to say that a family friend was here to say that he would have passed the message. My concern is, since when family friends have to pass message for a relative, when they already had our numbers that they could have called, right? Bringing over the body over here, they put her in a cubicle that Mark do not use. Now the body is there, waiting to be transferred. Still no ice, and they're not doing anything for it.
The family believes that bodies should be respected and handled with some level of dignity whilst at the hospital.
They have to have respect for people, death. We coming from all over for my mother, right? And this is what we're going to come to. I just traveled since yesterday, 24 hours, I didn't get 1 ounce of sleep. Come here to hear this problem with my mother. How would you feel? Would they like anybody do it to their family?
Meanwhile, another family is also claiming that the staff of the mortuary is not professional when preparing and storing dead bodies.
That these people just collecting your tax money and they are not giving you the proper service. So we need proper service for the people, not for us alone, for everyone else that who's having a dead that coming here. And we need our dead to be protected the way it's supposed to be.
Efforts to contact the chief executive officer of the Georgetown Public Hospital Corporation regarding complaints proved futile. Reporting for MTV News Update, Lashona Gomes, Cornelius.
The communities from Caledonia to Success on the east bank of Demerara are touted to see better days if the Community for Change and Development group is voted in at a local government election. This is according to the group's leader, Colonel Leon Bolin.
Well, we'll continue the program that we started during our last exploration in the council. Clean the drains, fix the roads, start collecting garbage for the people, try to provide recreation facilities for the youths.
Contestant in Constituency 7 is a Community for Change and Development group spearheaded by Colonel Leon Bowlin. The group's slogan is Making a Difference, Vote the Shield. Bowlin is certain that they will be successful with all the work they have already completed. Bowlin added, his group is non-political and their aim is to assist everyone, regardless of their political affiliation. Kipani Jordan reporting for MTV's News Update.
Hindus in and around the world will tomorrow celebrate Diwali, known as the Festival of Lights.
With thousands of Guyanese to celebrate Diwali, the People's Progressive Party, PPP, is extending Diwali greetings to all Guyanese, especially to those of the Hindu community. The VPP recognizes the significance of Diwali and what it means to the people of Guyana and the rich culture it originates from. Meanwhile, the People's National Congress Reform, PNC, also extends special greetings to the entire Hindu community. The party notes that as Diwali is celebrated, it will remain committed to ensuring continued unity and diversity in the country. The annual Diwali motorcade is expected to commence at Campbell Avenue, Georgetown, hence to the Chaturmarga Community Center ground. The message of Diwali, also known as Deepavali, seeks to inspire all to work in the best interest of all Guyanese, in order that the light of prosperity manifests itself in their lives. Diwali occurs on the night of Amavasya in the month of Kartik, which is considered to be the darkest night on the Hindu calendar and marks the return of Lord Rama after 14 years in exile. Reporting for MTV News Update, Lashona Gomes, Cornelius.
Marcelin Griffith with today's court roundup.
A food vendor was today brought before Principal Magistrate Judy Latchman on a threatening language charge. 26-year-old Randy Scotland of South Rumfeld pleaded not guilty to the charge, which read that on November 2 at Heaven's Place, North Georgetown, he used threatening language towards Sarah Goodman. According to reports, the defendant told the virtual complainant she was lucky he did not strap up or it wouldn't have ended nicely. The prosecution had no objections to bail, which was granted at the sum of $20,000. Scotland is scheduled to return to court on November 7. Meanwhile, a laborer was today hauled before the court on a robbery under arms charge. Calvin Belgrave, 24, of MN Bent Street, Georgetown, pleaded not guilty to the charge, which alleged that on November 2 at Breakdown on Cornhill Street, Georgetown, while in the company of others and armed with a knife, he robbed Delon Anderson of one Samsung cell phone via $36,000 and $2,000 cash. The prosecution objected to bail based on the prevalence and seriousness of the offense. He was remanded until November 19. In another matter, a vendor and father of four was today placed before Principal Magistrate Judy Latchman on several charges. 32-year-old David Bernard of Lot 17 Broad Street, Charlestown, pleaded not guilty to all charges against him. The first charge alleged that on November 1 at Broad Street, Charlestown, he had in his possession one 9mm pistol while not being the holder of a firearm license. The second charge stated that on the same day at the aforementioned address, he had in his possession 15 matching rounds of ammunition while not being the holder of a firearm license. The third charge read that on the same day at Lot 17 Broad Street, Charlestown, he unlawfully assaulted Jessica Bell. The prosecution had no objections to bail for the assault charge, but objected to bail on the two firearm-related charges based on the prevalence and seriousness of the offense. The court heard that on the day in question, Bell made a report to the police after the defendant allegedly slapped her. When Rangs showed up to arrest him, he allegedly took out the firearm and ammunition and threw it next to a zinc fence. He was told of the offense, arrested, and charged. Bernard was granted $20,000 bail for the assault charge, but was remanded to prison until November 8 for the other two charges. Finally, a mason and father of one was today brought before Chief Magistrate Anne McLennan on two charges. Kester Johnson, 20, of 189 Half Mile Wismer, Linden, pleaded not guilty to the first charge of breaking and entering the home of Tia Hohenkirk on August 21 and stealing a cell phone valued $45,000. The second charge against him read that on August 24 at Wismer Police Station, while being in lawful custody, he escaped. To this charge, he pled guilty. The court heard that Johnson was previously charged in April of this year for break and enter and larceny and was on a 2-year suspended sentence. He was sentenced to 1 year in prison for escaping from custody and was remanded until November 28 for the break and enter and larceny charge. Reporting for MTV's Court Roundup, Celine Griffith.
Coming up after the break, MTV's sports update and more. Stay with us.
Vámonos pa'l baño, que nadie nos está viendo. Si no me conoce, nos vamos conociendo. Sé que suena loco, pero me gusta tanto. Estar un día más así yo no lo aguanto. Vámonos a la luna, vámonos pa'l cine. Vamos a darle un beso.
somos novios, pues somos panas. Oh, 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 oh.
John Lee Styles, simply different.
Christmas is for celebrating. Imagine having a warm, cozy Christmas with your loved ones, with your favorite food, presents, and all the things you want. With GBTI's Christmas loan, you get to celebrate in style like never before. Simply apply for your loan between October and December for quick approvals and a chance to win a trip for two to Trinidad, compliments of Liat, an overnight trip for two at the Arawai Resort, a weekend for two at the Gaina Marriott. Visit your nearest GBTI bank and apply today. Terms and conditions apply. GBTI, we see Christmas through your eyes.
I want to celebrate Christmas with friends and family every day.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for a single vision lens and $12,000 for a bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
Did you know almost one-third of deaths in Guyana are heart-related? Chronic inflammation is the root cause of atherosclerosis, the process that leads to cholesterol-clogged arteries. You can now lower high triglyceride levels with Omega XL and reduce the dangerous inflammation that causes these problems. So to ensure a healthy heart and reduce your risk of disease, get your Omega XL today. Live long, stay strong with Omega XL.
Everything is connected. Our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Puran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
Rights and responsibilities of a voter. As a registered voter, it is your right to vote as your conscience tells you, attend political meetings and campaign rallies, and to expect an orderly and peaceful election, free from fear, violence, or intimidation. It is also your responsibility to take part in the election of persons who would be making decisions about your community that affect you directly and indirectly. Know the various voluntary groups, political parties, individual candidates, and their stance on important communal issues. Vote only once for the voluntary group or political party of your choice, and once for the constituency candidate of your choice. Know the boundaries of the municipality or neighborhood democratic council in which you live. Know the boundaries of the constituency in which you live, and giving other voters equal opportunities to vote. For more information, contact GCOM on 225-0277-9 or 223-9653. Email pro@gcom.org.gy or visit GCOM's website at www.gcom.org.gy.
Welcome to Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., Guyana's sole distributor of NP and Ultra Lubricants, SKF bearings, seal and belts, international trucks and parts, and Napa batteries. With a bond capacity of 30,000 square foot, we offer superior brands at affordable prices and the best after-sales service. ISG supplies sustainable integrated solutions to make your business a growing success. Visit us at our new main office at Lot 4Q, Peters Hall, ISG, the best opportunity to make the right choice.
Welcome to MTV's Sports Update. West Indies Next Gen 221 stars plucked out for the Caribbean Premier League 2018 were tipped to challenge Indian more than their ODI and test sides had done.
Their batsmen cobbled only 109 for 8, but their bowlers, led by debutant Quick Osan Thomas, ambushed India's top order and ran them close before Dinesh Karthik and Kurnal Pata, also on debut, ushered the host home. Scores in the match: West Indies 109 for 8 from 20 overs, Pavin Allen 27, Kima Paul 15, Kieran Pollard 14, Shea Hope 14, Shimron Hetimaya 10, Kuldeep Yagdev to pick up 3 for 13 from India. In reply, the host reached 110 for 5 from 17.5 overs with Dinesh Karthik 31, Kurnal Pandya 21, Manish Pandey 19 and Lokesh Rahul 16. Carlos Brathwaite picked up 2 for 11 and Oshin Thomas 2 for 21. Here are the highlights of the low-scoring affair.
Good shot, take 4. Good delivery, celebrations, and yes, the finger goes up. There he goes. Oh, hesitation, both batsmen at one end. Throw is not great, but ample time to take the bails off. Second one.
Trying to make some room. This is a quick outfield, and it'll get there. Up in the air, it's very high. Dinesh Karthik calling for it. He's the man with the gloves. And takes it neatly. The third wicket, gone. Goes for it, and when Pollard goes for it,
this could be out. Yes! Big wicket always, Pollard. This could be, yes!
Yeah!
Strong appeal and given.
Such a good player appeal and given. Another wicket. Hit, and it goes straight to Umesh Yadav. High in the air, and get onto the boundary.
All you have to do on this ground is just find the gap.
Tickled away fine.
Well, that should be taken. That's miles up in the air. And it's taken. Darren Bravo, good catch. 35 for 3.
Straight to the mat. It was Darren Bravo once again.
See, difficult. But he's got a 6. Is it in the gap? Yes, it is. Another boundary. Glorious shot.
Catch it!
Another. They've got the 5th. It's the important wicket of Manish Pandey.
Flicked nicely. Flicked very, very nicely. Is that it?
The first of 5 ICC Women's World T20 warm-up matches scheduled to be played in Guyana kicked off yesterday with Bangladesh taking on Ireland at the National Stadium, Providence.
The Asian ladies took control of the encounter by 6 wickets, effortlessly chasing the Irish ladies' 84. Bangladesh got off to the perfect start after opting to bat first, with bowler Jahanara Alam eliminating Irish batswoman Claire Shillington. Irish batswoman 17-year-old Gabby Lewis hit Bangladesh's captain Salma Khatun for a boundary with the 5th ball. As the game progressed, wickets continued to fall at regular intervals. Despite looking threatening to the Asian women, Gabby Lewis was the only Irish batter with a strike rate over 100, but she was removed for 15 inclusive of 2 boundaries. In pursuit of Ireland's 84, Bangladesh effortlessly blazed through with a massive power, securing 3 runs. However, after their power play, wickets began to fall in favor of the Irish women. Faragana Hoke and Sanjida Islam ensured Ireland and Kimberly Garth could cause no further damage by leading their team to victory with an unbeaten 48 run. Bangladesh, finishing on 86 for 4 with 32 balls left to spare, secured the first warm-up match by 6 wickets. In addition to the warm-up match, the two teams engaged in a super-over match for further practice. The super-over bowled by Ahmed saw Ireland batting first and scoring 5 for 2, losing Shillington and Lewis. Bangladesh easily chased their target, finishing on 8 in the super-over. Prior to the official matches scheduled for Friday, the Bangladeshi women have gained full confidence ahead of their first game. Chelsea Griffith, reporter for MTV's Sport Update.
Meanwhile, India's preparation for the Women's World T20 are in full swing, and the Harmanpreet Kaur team is making sure to go into the tournament as one of the favourites. The Indian women's team registered its second successful win in the warm-up matches as they beat defending champions and host West Indies by 5 wickets in a rain-trenched 220 match at College. India had earlier beaten South Africa by 3 runs in their first warm-up game. Today, India rode on Poonam Yadav, Radhav Yadav and Aradi Reddy's outstanding bowling spells to restrict West Indies to 115 for 8 after the host won the toss and opted to bat first. West Indies skipper Hayley Matthews top-scored with 41 runs off 37 balls, while Sherman Campbell added 22 runs off 28 balls, but the rest of the batters failed miserably. For India, Poonam, Radhan and Aradi grabbed 2 wickets each, while Herman Pradeep bagged 1 wicket. The rain came down and India was set a revised target of 75 in the 12 overs, and India won with just 3 balls to spare. Devendra Dottin was the pick of the West Indies bowlers, taking 3 wickets. Homebred Cleveland Ford continued his stellar performance with a phenomenal performance in the second leg of the South American 10K road race when he secured a win over second place the Winston Michiner at the National Park yesterday afternoon.
It was a nail-biting race with Cleveland Ford finishing in a time of 34 minutes and 7 seconds to cop the top prize of $1,000, with second place being awarded to Winston Missinger, who finished in 34 minutes and 9 seconds, followed by Cleveland Thomas, who came in third with a time of 34 minutes and 18 seconds. Last weekend in Suriname, it was a similar win for the trio. The second leg of the race sped off along the route of GTNT's Earth Station on Carfesta Avenue and proceeded towards the University of Guyana's road onto the Rupert Craig Highway and returned to the National Park for the finish. Grenada's Kenesha Pascal copped the top place in the women's category, followed by Guyana's Shima Tyrell coming in second, Kezra Murray in third and Alia Moore in fourth. The third and final leg of the South American 10K series is slated for Panama on Sunday, November 11. Chelsea Griffith reported for MTV's Sport Update.
And finally in sport, boxer Floyd Mayweather will fight kickboxer Tenshin Nasakawa in Japan on December 31 after signing a deal with a mixed martial arts company. Former 5-weight world champion Mayweather beat UFC's Conor McGregor in a boxing match in August 2017 to extend his perfect record to win 50. The format and rules for this fight with Nasakawa are yet to be decided. So it is more news after the break.
Welcome to Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., Guyana's sole distributor of NP and Ultra Lubricants, SKF Bearings, Seal and Belts, International Trucks and Parts, and Napa Batteries. With a bond capacity of 30,000 square foot, we offer superior brands at affordable prices and the best after-sales service. ISG supplies sustainable integrated solutions to make your business a growing success. Visit us at our new main office at Lot 4Q, Peters Hall, ISG. The best opportunity to make the right choice.
In the region, the first members of a large group of migrants traveling through Mexico towards the United States have arrived in the capital, Mexico City. About 450 people, mostly men and boys, were given temporary shelter at a sports stadium. They are part of a now 5,000-strong group known as a migrant caravan, which left Honduras on October 12. U.S. President Donald Trump says troops will be deployed to stop them crossing the U.S.-Mexican border. Critics have accused Mr. Trump of using people's fears of illegal immigration to fire up his supporters ahead of Tuesday's midterm elections. And internationally, Secretary of State Mike Pompeo has warned that the U.S. will exert relentless pressure on Iran unless it changes its revolutionary course. His comments came hours after the Trump administration restored all sanctions lifted under the 2015 nuclear deal, targeting core parts of Iran's economy. Iran's President Hassan Rouhani earlier struck a defiant tone, saying the country will continue selling oil. Mr. Pompeo told reporters that the Iranian regime has a choice. They can either do a 180-degree turn from its outlaw course of action and act like a normal country, or it can see its economy crumble. And that has brought us to the end of regional and international news. Now let's take a look at the Ghana Stock Exchange closing prices for trading session 798. Let's turn our attention to the Damar Harbour Bridge and the Burbies River Bridge schedules. And that's a wrap on today's broadcast. Before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. Government takes over Burbies River Bridge operations. Man chopped to death by brother-in-law. Guyanese urge to brace for heavy rainfall and possible flooding in the coming weeks. And in sport, West Indies batting collapse as India win first T20. Qatar rebroadcast at 23 hours today and at 6 hours 30 tomorrow. On behalf of our news and technical teams, I'm Sandy Ramutar, wishing you a happy Diwali from the management and staff of MTV 65. Good night.